Sri Krishna, Sri Krishna, Sri Krishna, Sri Krishna. Gurur Brahma, Gurur Vishnu, Gurur Devo Maheshwaraha, Guru Sakshat Param Brahma, Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha, Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha. 34th Sutra. Dehindriyadi sakala jada avabhasakatvena atma chidrupaha iti chidatmanu bhava siddhi samyak bhuyat. The rule is the illuminator and illumined. Between these two, what is our position? So here this inquiry is set in. Deha indriya adi sakala jada avabhasakatvena. Everything is illumined by us. The world, this is known by us. The world is known through our sense organs. Sense organs are also known by us. After we come in contact with the worldly objects through the sense organs, some experiences happen. Those experiences are also known by us. And these experiences happen in the mind. So, the condition of the mind, it is at peace, it is disturbed. This condition of the mind is also known by us. And the mind is also known by us. My mind is disturbed. Then the intellect, I have understood, this I understand, I know that I understood. But people don't understand me. In this manner, anything that is known, illumined, is jada. It's a rule. Like, I am the seer, Mike is the seen, drishya padartha. Therefore, the seer is sentient consciousness, the object seen is inert. I am the seer and this book is inert because the book is seen. I am the seer, I am seeing you all. You are all inert. See? What I see you also see you, isn't it? What you are, that I can't see. See, as much I see your body and discard it as inert, equally my body is also an object of knowledge, that is also inert. Therefore, it is said, jada avabhasakatvena atma chidrupaha. So, therefore, atma, the self, is the conscious being. Iti chidatmanu bhava siddhi samyak bhuyat. Thus, let me have this experience that I am the conscious being. See. Now to arrive at this I am the conscious being, what is required is, all that we are holding on to, we have to give up. See. That is why the mantra is, na karmana na prajaya dhanena tyage naike amrutatva manashu. We have to give up. So what are the things we are holding on to? The worldly things and beings. Then our sense organs, our body, our experiences, our memories, our achievements, our failures. All of these things are to be given up and we all give it up also. Because what is deep sleep? All these things are given up. So, in deep sleep, what is your experience? Two things. Aham kimapi na janami. I know nothing. But this I know, that I know nothing. So this I, who was illuminating the presence in the waking and the dream, and I, who is illuminating the absence of the deep sleep and samadhi. So who is this? The one who is illuminating both presence and absence. So that which is illuminating both presence and absence is beyond the presence and absence. Now be attentive. This flower is recognized as is as well as is not. Two things. Now the next step. Do we have this experience about ourselves? I am and I am not. This experience is not there. We cannot have the experience that I am not. If this experience is not there, that I am not, is it wise to call that I am? No need. See how simple it is. Therefore, that about which there is an option of is and is not is the jada, inert. And that about which there is no option of is and is not is the reality. So Jagrat is, Jagrat is not. Dream is not. Deep sleep is not. Samadhi is not. But do we have this option? That sometime I am, sometime I am not? No. Even the absence is illuminated by this reality that we are. Therefore, in Amrutanubhava, Sant Gyaneshwar says, Satchit Ananda, these are the three abuses given to the Lord. We may say Satchidananda, Satchidananda, but if you go deeply to understanding, why it is called as Sat when there is no possibility of Asat? There is no need. So calling the reality as Sat is an abuse. See? Similarly, Chit. When there is no possibility of being inert, what is the need of calling it as Chit? Everything gone. But you are still there. See friends, study Amrutanubhava. It's one of the most wonderful texts ever written on earth. See? It will definitely change our complete perspective of life. So, Dehendriyadi Sakala Jada Avabhasakatvena Atma Chidrupaha Iti Thus Chidatmanu Bhava Siddhi Samyak Bhuyat. Therefore, only one question you can play with. Do we have the experience of our absence? No. Do we have the experience of our birth? No. Do we have the experience of our growth? No. Do we have the experience of our death? No. That is all. Now who has come and who has gone? Second chapter, Bhagavan says this thing, but we mechanically chant and forget. I got such a back pain. Therefore, all our gods have got a smile on their face. They could be reading, but understands nothing. Just become simply aware of this. Childhood has come and gone, teenage has come and gone. There is one child in Chennai, his name is Anubhav. He was born in Bombay, so his mother and father, Swamiji, This is our first child, what should we name him? I said, you name him Anubhav. So he is named as Anubhav. So quiet, absolutely, nothing disturbs him. So suppose you give him something to eat, he will not sit in the chair and eat. He will properly sit on the floor. And he give it here, he will sit there. And with the proper rule, as if theoretically some shooting is going on, he is eating. So, when he was in Bombay, that time he was about 6 years or 5 years like that. This time when I went to Chennai, I met him. Huge, tall, brother. My God, is it you? See? He said, yes, what is there? I am me. Now for him, he is grown up. That experience is not there. For the onlooker, he is a huge structure. Because none of us have got the experience, we are growing. Therefore, whether you want or you don't want, you are divine. This is too much. Whether you know or you don't know, you are divine. Nay, 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 papoham papa karma. Therefore, this Atma Chidrupayati Chidatma Anubhava Siddhi Bhuyat. Keep your attention on this. So many things have come and gone. Whenever miseries come, we get influenced by misery. Then miseries go, we are still there. So nothing has really happened. Is all just appearing. There is one book which I had downloaded, but I could not read it so far. It's a very beautiful book. The name of the book is Holographic Universe. According to Konath Siddhanta, millions of atoms are crossing and the junction of those cross becomes solidified, and that is called as an object. Like when Mr. Modi gave his talks, holographic talks. How it happened? He was not there, but fully seen. Exactly the same way this world appears. It doesn't exist. See, my friends, like on the screen, each frame is still, but there is the sequence established. When the sequence is established, there is an appearance of the movement. So wherever there is a movement, there is a gati, the world is created. When the gati stops, as in samadhi or in deep sleep, immediately the world disappears. Therefore, unknowingly we all know suspension of gati is realization of truth. Because the reality supports the movement, but doesn't undergo any movement. Like the space supports all the changes, but itself never changes. In the same manner, we have supported all the changes till date, but we are the same. Becoming aware of this is Chidatmanubhava Siddhi Bhuyat Iti. Atmani kadachidapi apriya bhavena parama premaspadatvena cha atma parama ananda rupaiti anandanubhava siddhi samyak bhuyan. Atmani kadachidapi apriya abhavena. We may like something, we may not like something. This liking, disliking is possible about everything in this world. But when it comes to the I, there is no question of I dislike myself. What is the reason? Whatever is the source of happiness that we like, whatever is the source of misery that we don't like, because we like ourselves the most, because we are the most blissful. In Upanishad it comes, Atmanastu kamaya sarvam priyam bhavati. Everything in this world is dear for our sake. Few examples are given. The wife is dear to the husband, not for the sake of the wife, but for his own sake. The children are dear to the parents, not for the sake of the children, but their own sake. The Rasagulla is dear to the Bengali, not for the sake of the Rasagulla, but for his own sake. And we are dear to ourselves for our own sake. See? Because we are the source of all happiness. This is Atmani Kadachidapi Apriya Abhavena Parama Premaspadatvena. Because we are Parama Premaspada. We love ourselves the most. And Techa Atma Paramananda Rupa Iti, therefore Atma, the Self, is of the nature of supreme bliss. In this manner, Anandanubhava Siddhi Samyak Bhuyat. Therefore, what is the meaning of real Ananda? Be very attentive. These three words which are used, Satchidananda, let us analyze and understand them. Object is Sat, existing. The experience of the object happens in chit, the consciousness. So object is Rasagulla, existing. Chit, consciousness, is our tongue, where the knowledge of Rasagulla will take place. When they are separate from each other, it is a painful experience. Finish prayer quickly. See? And then, the Sat, Rasgulla, and Chit, the tongue, they are together. When this object lands on the tongue, then immediately what happens? Be attentive. Mouth closes, eyes close, and the distance between the two close in such a manner that they become one. Therefore, where Sat and Chit are one, that experience is called as Ananda. When Sat and Chit are separate, it is samsara. When Sat and Chit are not separate, it is Paramatma. Now, is it not our experience? I am Sat. I know I am Chit. So, do we have this experience in a sequence? Or is it a simultaneous experience? It's a simultaneous experience. We don't have like this, I am, I think, I know, I am, no. Because Sat and Chit are not two. This is what is called as Advaita Siddhi. But when we keep the God away, Dvaita, Dvaita, going to hell and heaven, then whole samsara comes. See, friends. Therefore, parama prada premas padatvena atma paramananda rupa iti. And the glimpses of this paramananda we get in deep sleep. In deep sleep, these glimpses of paramananda are on account of two things. One is, there is no sense of otherness. Because there is no sense of otherness, there is no desire. There is no sense of incompleteness. Therefore, there is no desire. See? Yet, however, this is a temporary phase. When this experience of deep sleep is lived in and through waking dream, etc., then we are living in meditation. Yanisha sarva bhutanam tasyam jagrati sayami yasyam jagrati bhutani sanisha pashyato mune apuryamanam achala pratishtam samudram apapravishanti yadvat tadvat kamayam pravishanti sarve sa shanti mapnoti na kama kami. Like the rivers pour millions of gallons of water every moment in the ocean doesn't overflow, and millions of gallons of water is evaporated in the summer months, the ocean doesn't lose anything. In the same manner, presence or absence of things and beings do not make any difference to this master. Tadvat kamayam pravishanti sarve. All the desires, desirable objects, etc., their presence and absence makes no difference. Sa shanti mapnoti. He attains peace. And na kama kami, not the one who is constantly desiring, it should be like that, it should be like that. Everything is perfectly all right. See, this is one most important practice, to remain in this world indifferent. You don't have to get involved with anything, with anybody, remain indifferent. That doesn't mean we are frustrated. See? So, how to remain indifferent without showing that you are not indifferent? Karnataka. See? When you go to somebody's marriage, just wish him happy marriage, happy wedding, and give them very big, big words. But you don't have to mean it. See? Just do this acting. The one who can act is devotee of Bhagavan Krishna. You know, Lord Shiva and Bhagavan Krishna, both of them are called as actors. Now, this Lord Shiva is Nataraj, Big B. See. And Kanhaiya Lal, Natavar, Var means the Supreme. Both of them are acting. One Arya Samaji person, he was telling me, Swamini, you people called Bhagavan Krishna, Bhagavan Krishna. What is Bhagavan in him? I said, forget about Krishna, tell me, are you married? He said, yes, I am married. I said, could you make your one wife happy? He said, no way. He made 16,000 wives happy. He has to be Bhagavan. You could not make even one wife happy, and who could maintain those big lot, and therefore Bhagavan Krishna doesn't have a family portrait. In no camera it will come. Bhagavan Rama is always a pati, patni. See, friends, therefore don't get carried away too much in this world. There is nothing serious. I have seen the most miserable people are those who are walking this religious path. Most miserable. I told you once, I went for begging. First of all, I went to a masjid. After the prayers were over, I was sitting outside. Nobody gave a pie. I got disgusted. I went to a church. Service was going on, neat, clean, well-dressed. After service was over, I was sitting outside, nobody gave. Then I went to a temple. There also I was sitting outside, so many people coming, going, nobody gave. I got frustrated. Finally, out of anger and frustration, I went to a pub and sat there outside. Within 15 minutes, it was filled. Then I shouted at God, why did he give the wrong address? All those going to these holy places are most unholy fellows. See, friends, don't get carried away by this world. It is nothing worth becoming serious about. So, Continuing further, abharupasya vishvasya bhanam bhasaka sannidhim vina kadajidapi na sambhavati iti bharupatma sarvagataha iti sarvagatatma anubhava siddhi samyak bhuyat. Abharupasya vishvasya bhanam. This world which is not self-illumined, it is vina bhasaka sannidhim, without the external light to illuminate, na kadachit api sambhavati, it is never possible. See, it is something like this. To see this book, how many lights are required? First the book is required, then the tube light is required, then my eyes are required, they should be in a proper relationship, then the book is seen. Okay, three factors, very good. If I had to see the light, do I need this book? Because the light is self-illumined. See, now bring the same principle here. Abharupasya. This world is there or not, unless it is illuminated by the knower, the world does not exist. See? Therefore, abharupasya vishvasya bhanam bhasaka sannidhim vina kadachidapi na sambhavati iti. Without the illuminator, the illumined cannot be proved to exist. Therefore, atma bharupaha sarvagataha iti. And everything in this world is illuminated, illumined. See, if you go a little deeper in your thinking and understanding, it is something like this. Be very attentive. It's a very deep thought. Everywhere, Paramatma is. If you stand in front of the wall, do you get your reflection? No. If you stand in front of the mirror, do you get reflection? Yes. So, there must be something wrong with our face. It is not reflected in the wall. No, not face. Face is the same. Then, it is the conditioning in front of whom we are standing. Mirror is a conditioning where reflection can happen. Wall is a conditioning where reflection doesn't happen. Does it mean, therefore, there is no reflection in the wall? Take an example, another one. You stand in front of a granite slab. Your reflection is not seen. Then polish it perfectly. Immediately reflection is coming. So, is it coming from inside? Then, earlier it was there, but it did not manifest. Be attentive. Exactly the same way. Chaitanya Paramatma is everywhere. This Chaitanya Paramatma does not manifest as Chaitana in the inert world, and manifest as Chetana in the Panchakoshas. Be very attentive. Therefore, Chetana is a manifestation of Chaitanya. So, Chaitanya is common. This Chaitanya can manifest as Chetana, life, in the Panchakoshas, but the same Chaitanya cannot manifest as Chetana in the other objects. And therefore, it appears to be inert. But in fact, in everything and being, it is the same Chaitanya. In one place, it is manifesting as Chaitana. In other place, it is unable to manifest as Chaitana. Therefore, life is not Paramatma. Life is an expression of Paramatma. Light is not electricity. Light is an expression of electricity under a particular condition. But then why the electricity is not expressing light through me? You switch on and hold it, you will get light everywhere. See, friends, with this vision, when you look at the world, Then you will see, according to our Vedanta Shastra, stones, bricks, everything is Paramatma. See? Then there won't be obsession. The murtis cannot be God, destroy them. See? Arya Samajis, they have this funny thing. They don't believe in Murti Puja because the influence of Islam. So, Vedic mantras, but no Murti Puja. And they'll be keeping the picture of their, Swami Dayananji Maharaj. That is allowed. See, what is an object? Anything which is conditioned by time, space, is object. When you pray facing only to a particular direction, you are holding to an object. If Paramatma is without name and form, nirguna nirakar, why a particular direction? Time, or rather space, and time at a particular time. Anything which is conditioned by time and space is an object. And to insist that God is without form is acceptance that God is with form. One person, a young boy, said, Swamiji, I don't believe in God. I said, don't believe, who cares? No, but I don't believe. I said, never mind. Is anybody objecting? Nobody is. Why you are insisting? Do you know why you are insisting? Because you believe in God. There is no reason. All the atheists are sincerely believers in God, but they don't have courage to accept it. Cowards. See? Therefore, avarupasya vishvasya bhanam bhasaka sannidhim vina kadachita vina sambhavati. So the illuminator is necessary to illuminate the inert world, and this bharupatma, this sentient, the pure consciousness is sarvagata, is ever present everywhere in everything. Nay, everything is present in it. Now I'll break another head of yours. When we say God is beyond time, this is an insult to God. When we say God is everywhere, another insult to God. As if space is a reality and in that the God is. It is the other way around. Time, space and object, they are in the reality. The God is not in anything. We are only calling the reality by different names. Like we call only the same man by different names. And he is a son, he is a husband, he is a father. Because our perception is relational. It is not absolute. Therefore, sarvagata atma iti sarvagata atma anubhava siddhi samyak bhuyat. And therefore, let you have this experience being all pervading. Now see, what is this experience being all pervading? I is all pervading in my body. Therefore, be attentive. Anything which is included in the definition of I don't hate. Think of your large intestine, where a lot of fecal material is stored. Think about it. You cannot have hatred in your mind. Let it come out. Don't think. Don't want to look at it. Simply flush it out. Who wants to see? Because it is no more I. Another example. This happened in Delhi. One girl used to sit right in the front. And a Punjabi girl. One day I went somewhere for breakfast. She also came. I said, hey, you came here also. There is no lecture here. Did they invite you for breakfast? Swamiji, this is my house. Because I never know who had to go. I just go. Swamiji, vaha ja rahe hain? I don't require any invitation. Khane se matlab? So, I said, okay, then let mama prepare, you sit with me. I said, give me your hand. And I was playing with her hand. She had very long nails. I said, hey, I have never seen such beautiful long nails. Do you have to take any food to grow them like that, special food? Or how they have become so red and nice? Do you have to eat lot of carrots or what? Swamiji, they are colored and they are not actual. Half of them are actual, half of them are fake. And they are like that, you know, they're very beautiful. It was all over. Next day she came for the lecture. She had cut all the nails. Say, what happened? Swamiji, I was feeling very embarrassed. I removed all of them. I said, never mind, bring them. I like them very much. No, I have thrown them. Be attentive. When the nails were included in the definition of I, they are a point of beauty. The moment they are separated, they are a garbage. When we include the whole world in the definition of I, whom will you love and whom will you hate? Atma upamena sarvatra samam pasyati arjuna sukham va yadi va dukham sayogi paramo mataha. He who is able to be happy in the happiness of others, and he who is able to extend a helping hand to a needy person, he alone has merged in the totality. See? When we are happy in the happiness of others, when there is a scratching somewhere and we scratch one part of me, hand, other part of me where the scratching is the hand, the leg, when it is scratching, ananda, brahmananda. We never suffer. The happiness in the happiness of others. And if there is some pain somewhere, same our hand goes and slowly trying to care. Oh, it's so painful, so painful. Because everywhere I alone is. This is, may it happen. Therefore, sarvagata atmanubhava siddhi samyak bhuyan. Asajjada dukkhatmaka ahankara dibhyaha vilakshanataya pratikullena satya jnanananda rupena anchati prakashati iti pratyagatmanubhava siddhi samyak bhuyat. Asat, inert, and asat means non-existent. Jada, inert, dukkha, misery. Atmaka, that which is of the nature of non-existent or inert or misery. What is that? Ahankara dibhyaha. See, the whole prakriti. The five dhanendriyas, five karmendriyas, pancha pranas, mana buddhi chitta ahankar, the whole subtle body, including the gross body, it is asad, it is not real. Then, tebhya vilakshanataya, exactly opposite to that. What is the opposite of this thing? Will be satya jnana ananda. So the world is non-existent, the truth is real. Then the world is jada, the truth is jnana swarupa. The world is dukkhatmaka, the truth is ananda. So satya jnanam ananda rupena anchati prakashate iti. So that which is illumined as conscious, blissful existence, that is pratyagatma, that is our essential nature. May this experience be established in me. Satyam jnanam anantam brahma yo veda nihitam guhayam parame vyomannas soshnate sarvan kamansa brahmana vipaschiteti. In Taittiriya Upanishad, the Upanishad says, Satyam jnanam anantam brahma, the Satchidananda, infinite, non-dual, absolute reality, Brahma, yo veda nihidam guhayam. He who comes to discover this as the substratum of the panchakoshas. Here guha means panchakoshas. Annamaya, pranamaya, manomaya, vijnanamaya, anandamaya. He who comes to discover the substratum of these panchakoshas, yo veda nihidam guhayam, parame vyomanna inda chidakash, then so shrute sarvan kaman sa, be attentive. All his desires stand fulfilled simultaneously at the same time. Our desires are fulfilled in a sequence. Therefore, one desire is fulfilled, second desire comes. Second is fulfilled, third one comes. Third is fulfilled, fourth one comes. But when all the desires stand fulfilled simultaneously, thereafter no more life for fulfillment of the desires. That doesn't mean the life will become dumb. No, the difference will be like the movement of the waters in the river and the movement of the waters in the ocean. The waters in the river have to move because it is a need to reach the destination, the goal, not yet reached. And what about the water's movement in the ocean? It is expression of fulfillment. Ananda che dohi ananda taranga. Tukaram Maharaj says, it is bliss manifest. Therefore, a master established in the truth can never be frustrated, depressed, dejected, and the face is so disgusting, nobody wants to go. No. See, it's all bliss, happiness. And where from this happiness comes? Because sarvan kaman saha ashnute. Because all the desires stand fulfilled at once for all. No more desires further. Therefore, my friends, again and again this comes in our scriptures. Real spiritual life is not fulfillment of desires, but getting freedom from desires. Any desire we have, it will make us disturbed, miserable. Our experience, when we have to catch a flight in the morning, so we decide, let me sleep early, taking dinner so that I can get up early morning, finish bath and get ready to go to work or to airport. So initial part you do it, finish the food early, go to bed. And then suppose you have to get up at 3 o'clock, you slept at 8 o'clock, 8 to 3, you will be waking up at least 396 times. Only one desire, that you have to catch the flight. Now with one desire destroys our whole night. We have got Himalayan desires, destroys our whole life. And what is our desires? What others should do, that we decide. Let them do whatever they want. But is it not, this is our, not our culture, this is not our tradition, these cultural fellows are useless. See, there is one very sweet girl, Cobra girl. You know Cobra? Cobra means cockroach the Brahman. They call her Cobra. Very intelligent, very beautiful, well built. Did her engineering softy, MS, and through that company she was exported for offshore project. So in her group there were about 5-6 of them, they went. In a country where nobody talks English, all are Germans, Germany, in Holland they went. And now they have nobody to go after the work hours, then they are together going to hotels, together going for seeing the things. The same group. And after 2-3 years, when this girl decided to come home, at least to meet the parents, one boy who was a very good friend of hers, and she had no intention about anything that she will marry him or all that. But what was going on in his mind, nobody knew. So, when she went to the airport, he was also there. Hey, how come? No, I am also booked on the same flight. As if it has happened. He did it. And then after the flight took over, he spoke to those air hostesses and planned a big way. That after this time, when everything is settled, then make the announcement. He bent before her on his knees and presented a ring. I propose you my heart in that aeroplane. She said that I couldn't say yes or no because there was no reason I could reject him. He is a good boy, but he belonged to a different community and he is the darker side. And she was like a, you know, European fresh and those funny kind of eyes. See? And I couldn't say yes, no. And when I landed over there, and then I thought, you know, what is wrong, what he has done? Anyway, I had to get married. And he's a good person from a good family. So she told her parents, in the house, Dharma Kshetre, Kuru Kshetre, Sama Veda Yudhsava. All tamasha started. So, go to Swamiji and ask him. It is not according to our culture. So, when she came and talked to me, I found there is nothing wrong in that. I said, oh, get married, very good, as long as you are happy. The father said, Swamiji, you also told yes, but this is not in our culture. I said, tell me the spelling of culture. Culture. Say, what do you understand by culture? I said, do you guarantee that the boy that you will select for her will be good? No, I can't guarantee. Then she has found out, let her be happy and encash this to enslave both of them for the whole life. If you fight now, you break their marriages, it will be a lifelong problem for you. If you are so much concerned, keep your daughter inside the house, lock and key, and with that black thing, penguin. Don't allow her to go. But when they are going in the open world, then accept what is the time of the situation and accordingly do it. Okay, Swamiji, when you say like that, as if they are obliging me. Koi leke dalare mein haath kaale. Then the marriage was done. Now few years have passed. Swamiji, that boy is really so good. We would never have found out such a wonderful boy. He cares for her so much. Now see, what happened to your culture? Therefore, this, you know, the dharma, dharma, durandar, I am very afraid of them. We have to be adaptive according to the today's time. Otherwise, go and sit in a corner and lead a life through, you know, those small holes. That's it. That is not life. Therefore, satya jnana ananda rupena prakashanchati tat pratyakatma namo siddhi samyak bhuyat. In short, when we discover the happiness in the happiness of others, we are abiding in the truth. We don't have to impose our views, our ways on anyone. There is no need. We all have come in this world to go our own way. That's it. Then, पश्चात भासमानस्य जडस्य प्रथमतः भासमानं चैतन्यमेव वास्तवं स्वरूपमिति निश्चित्य जडम उपेक्ष चिन्मात्रमेव चित्तं निरंतरं सम्यक् भूयात्। नाउ दिस इज द पॉइंट प्रोबब्ली आई टोल्ड यू, इट केम हियर नाउ आल्सो। पश्चात भासमानस्य जडस्य प्रथमतः 38th वर्स। पश्चात भासमानस्य जडस्य प्रथमतः भासमानं चैतन्यमेव, बी अटेंटिव, every object reveals itself, the presence of everything is revealed by itself, but our attention goes not on that chaitanya which is revealing its own presence, but goes on the conditioning through which it is expressing. Now to understand this, take this example. See, this I told you probably. One of my friend wanted some advice to work on for 1 year. So I told him this advice. I said, look here, where you are standing there near the wall, near the door, close the door and switch off the light. So he switched off the light. What do you see? Nothing. Very good. Now switch on the light. Now what do you see? He said, I see the furniture, the table, your laptop, you, the water bottle. I said, go ahead. He said, that's all, what more? I said, I see something different. I am seeing the light. I said, I see something more different. I see electricity. Now see, when we are preoccupied with the worldly objects, we forget the light that is illuminating the worldly objects. And when we give too much importance to the light, we forget that which is expressing as light. Now out of these three, the objects, the light that is illuminating the objects and electricity, which is the reality? Because we are preoccupied in the objectivity in our life, the pure conscious self is neglected. This is what is meant here. Paschat bhasamanasya jadasya. So the jada vastu, the objects are illuminated afterwards. First the light comes and then the objects are illuminated. But the light is never perceived by us, only the objects. The reason being, the nascent light cannot be seen. Like between you and me, the light is there. We don't see that light. But when the same light lands on a surface, then there is a reflected light. So what we see is a daylight. We don't see sunlight. Sunlight is dark. The light that we see, a daylight, it is not sunlight. It is reflected light. Otherwise, deep into the cosmos, why there is darkness? Because there is no object on which the light should fall and reflect. See, friends, therefore, paschat bhasamanasya jadasya prathamataha bhasamanam chaitanyameva. In the same manner, before any object is revealed, unless there is a chaitanya, the object cannot be revealed. In Vedantic language, it is said, drushyavachinna chaitanya and drashtavachinna chaitanya, when they two come together, then the knowledge happens. So, drushya padartha is also chaitanya, pure consciousness. The seer is also pure consciousness. When these two, anode and cathode, when they come together, then the knowledge happens. This is what is mentioned here. Paschal bhasamanasya jadasya. So the inert object is illuminated later. First it is the light that comes. So prathamataha bhasamanam chaitanyameva. So unless there is a chaitanya, no object can ever exist. So vastavam swarupam iti. Therefore everything in this world is shuddha chaitanya matra and nothing else. On the basis of this, it is established that when Santa Ganeshwar was ridiculed, your name is Jnana and that male buffalo is also dhyana. So are you one? He said, of course we are one. And whatever he chanted, that buffalo chanted. Why? Because Chaitanya is one, they are not two. Our words, our children also don't listen. And when Sandhya Gyaneshwar chanted, even the buffalo listened. See our depth. All right. Narayana. So, Paschad Vasamana Sajrasya Prathamada Vasavanam Chaitanya Meva Vastavam Swarupamiti Nishchitya Jadam Upeksha Chinmatrameva Chittam Nirantaram Samyak Bhuyat. Therefore, do not give undue importance to the worldly things. That is why, you know, many Mahatmas, they give one extreme importance to feeding the people. If you go to Jaitpur in Gujarat, where Jalaram Bapa's sthan is there, whole day anybody can go and eat. Because normal people, what we do, we use the people and love the things. But the Chaitanya is more conspicuously manifested in the living beings. See? So, when we start respecting the beings, we are in a close proximity to the consciousness. See? That is why Kabirji used to say that we do the Parthiva Vigraha Puja. We do the puja of the stones, bricks, nothing wrong. And those murtis are made by human being. So the murtis made by human being, in that we suspect God. But the murtis made by a God, in them we don't suspect God. Therefore the rule is, we must love, respect the beings and use the things. But we do the other way around. We love the things and use the beings. So, jadam upeksha chinmatram eva chittam nirantaram samyak bhuyan. Thus keep your attention again and again on this conscious being. And this can happen by a simple technique. Chittam. Remove the objectivity factor from your mind. Objectless awareness happens. And we will come to know, whenever we give importance to anything in this world, positive importance or negative importance, that object enters our mind. And when anything objectively enters our mind, the samsara begins. Then consciousness is reduced to the mind. Like when a boy wants to get married to a girl, he gets married, then what happened? Man is reduced to the husband. So husband is the reduced edition of man. Further he is reduced when he becomes a father. Further he is reduced when he becomes the father-in-law. Further he is reduced when he becomes a grandfather. Further he is reduced from the sublime falling to the ridiculous. Buried under all imaginary non-existing things. See, friends, let us not allow ourselves to be drowned from the sublime glory that we are. Therefore, chittam chitcha vijaniyat. Mind is consciousness if objectivity is removed. Therefore, this point I told you, thoughts always take us away from ourselves. Any thought you take, any question you ask, That about which there is no question, that is Paramatma. Then what is that about we don't have question? You find out. You don't get a spoon feeding. Work little bit. Then we come to know, we have no doubt, no question about our presence. We may, our mind may not be present, but we are present here. See? So may this consciousness, chit, be ever our essential nature. May we abide in this experience. Now the question is, how much time and energy it takes, efforts it takes to discover that we are Chaitanya, we are pure consciousness. That much time, energy and effort, as much is required for a husband to become a man. Now tell me, what will you do? We don't know. Arey yaar, you are husband, you should know. This is one very simple technique. Don't take wife seriously. How to do that? Again, that also a question. How to do that? When she talks, you keep quiet. When she is quiet, you don't talk. Om Purnamadaha Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishate Om Shanti 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 Harihi Om Sri Guru Vyo Namaha Harihi Om.